In this video, I'm talking about cochlear implants for unilateral hearing loss and single-sided deafness. Coming up. Hi guys, Cliff Olson, Doctor of Audiology and founder of Applied Hearing Solutions in Anthem, Arizona. And on this channel, I cover a bunch of hearing related information to help make you a better informed consumer. So if you're into that, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget to click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. Whether you were born deaf in one ear, or you experienced a sudden sensorineural hearing loss, or even developed an acoustic neuroma that rendered one ear completely ineffective, you have a variety of different treatment options at your disposal. Some of these treatment options are the contralateral routing of signal, otherwise known as cross treatment, and you also have bone conduction treatment, both of which I have discussed in detail in other videos. While these are both effective treatment options to be able to hear sound from your deaf side by taking that sound and putting it into your better ear, there are still a few limitations, and the main one being that you never actually get back true binaural hearing. Binaural hearing, otherwise known as hearing with two ears, offers some significant improvements over hearing with just one ear, such as being able to understand speech better in a quiet and noisy situation, and having more ease of listening. That being said, more neurons actually get fired inside of your brain, which gives you a better ability to process information. But perhaps the single biggest thing about being able to hear with two ears is that you can actually localize where sound is coming from. Just imagine that you're inside of your house and your cell phone is ringing and you have no idea where that cell phone is at because it requires two ears to be able to determine which direction sound is coming from. And if you have only one ear that works, you're not going to be able to do that. Now don't get me wrong, bone conduction and cross treatment are absolutely phenomenal treatment options for individuals with hearing in only one ear. That being said, they do not give you back the ability to hear with both ears. However, there is another less common treatment option that is more commonly thought of for individuals with bilateral deafness, and that is a cochlear implant. A cochlear implant actually has the ability to somewhat restore hearing in a deaf ear by completely bypassing all of the traditional structures of hearing. This is how it works. First, sound is picked up by the microphones on a sound processor. The processor converts this sound into a digital signal that is then transferred to the coil. The coil then sends this information to an implant that is underneath your skin. The implant then sends this signal through an electrode to the cochlea, which is your hearing organ. Your auditory nerve fibers pick up these digital signals in the form of electrical impulses. These impulses travel up the nerve to the brain, where your brain interprets the sound, which results in hearing. By giving hearing back to the deaf ear, while not guaranteed, could restore some aspect of binaural hearing to include localization ability, which, by now you know, is something that you just can't get from cross treatment or bone conduction treatment. A few weeks ago, the FDA approved the Med-L cochlear implant system as the first cochlear implants for the treatment of single-sided deafness and asymmetrical hearing loss. The press release announcing this specifically indicated that the Med-L cochlear implant systems, including Synchrony and the recently FDA-approved Synchrony 2, are now indicated for individuals aged 5 years and older with single-sided deafness who have profound sensorineural hearing loss in one ear and normal hearing or mild sensorineural hearing loss in the other ear. Or individuals aged 5 years and older with asymmetrical hearing loss who have profound sensorineural hearing loss in one ear and mild to moderately severe sensorineural hearing loss in the other ear, with a difference of at least 15 decibels in pure tone averages between ears. Prior to this FDA approval, cochlear implants were already being used to treat single-sided deafness just with an off-label use, which basically means that the FDA never actually approved it. Now, just because the FDA has approved a cochlear implant for the treatment of single-sided deafness, it does not guarantee that you'll be able to get a cochlear implant to treat your condition. There are specific candidacy requirements that must be met in order to get implanted. For adults, you must receive limited benefit from unilateral amplification, basically meaning putting a hearing aid in the affected ear. Then you must score less than 5% words correct in quiet on the CNC word list on the ear to be implanted. For children, aided speech perception tests using developmentally appropriate monosyllabic word lists must also score 5% or less in the ear to be implanted. Both adults and children must have at least 1 month of experience wearing a hearing aid, a cross device, or another relevant device with no reported subjective benefit. The other potential barrier to implantation would be cost. There are insurance companies out there already who would be willing to pay for cochlear implants for individuals with single-sided deafness, but this is definitely not the norm, and it typically takes insurance companies a little while to follow the FDA's lead. And with the private pay costs of surgery and technology ranging anywhere between $30,000 and $50,000 or more for a single cochlear implant, it's definitely possible to privately pay for cochlear implantation, but it's just gonna cost you what it would take to buy a really nice new car. That being said, don't let cost be the main deterrent preventing you from getting a cochlear implant if you feel that that is the best treatment option for you. With enough appeals to an insurance company, there is the possibility that they will end up paying for the treatment for you. And if they don't, there are some charitable organizations out there who may be able to help you cover at least a portion of your treatment. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments section below. If you liked the video, please share it. And if you want to see other videos just like this one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I'll see you next time.